Hello, folks. I have another record I wanted to share with you. It's kind of a unique one, if I may say so. It is the Queen of the Night aria, sung by Maria Galvani, recorded, I would say, right around 1906, give or take a little bit. It's a very unique performance, but this is a very unique record. If you look carefully, you'll see that it's a Victrola label, but if you look toward the bottom, you'll see RCA Victor Company. Camden, New Jersey. Now, these are markings of the late 1930s. And actually, if you take a look over here, let's take a look on the other side. It's kind of a neat thing here on the back of the record. You'll see, I'll just put it right on the turntable. It's probably best doing it that way. And just slowly turning it around. Really quite nice. It's the RCA Victor one-sided mark. It even has grooves going through it, so I guess in theory you could play through it. I don't know what it would say, but it's a very, very late one-sided record. Obviously, it was specially made. That's the only thing I can figure. Now, about this performance, it's probably the most unique performance of the Queen of the Night aria I have heard outside of Florence Foster Jenkins. Now, in the case with Jenkins, occasionally she hit the right note. In this case, Galvani hits all the notes, but she hits them in a very strange way. When she gets to the staccato of this, I can't fathom another word to kind of compare it to than Gatling gun. It's like a Gatling gun effect. She sings it three times as fast as anyone else would ever sing it. And although she's hitting all the notes, it's kind of frightening sounding. It doesn't it's artistic, but in a very bizarre way. Maybe you might like it. I find it a little like disconcerting. It's so fast. It's almost like they sped the record up, slowed it down. But they couldn't do this. This is an acoustic record from around 1906. So I'd like to let you hear this most remarkable recording. The machine's all wound up, and it's showtime because this is indeed a performance of performances. Now, it's not the worst Queen of the Night. As I said, I will give the prize to Florence Foster Jenkins. But the fastest Queen of the Night is definitely this one.